Anyway, what does Conan do? Which few games do? Well, first of all, we have 5-1 sound effects, a full surround sound effect environment, and that's like every game these days has that. But what we do on top of that is to have 5-1 music. All the music in the game is 5.1, meaning that it blends so much nicer with the rest of the atmosphere, and it also gives a great dimension to the music because most of the Conan music is orchestral. It's huge and epic, and it really deserves kind of a space, which is kind of the concert hall or something like that. And I'm going to show you an example or play an example afterwards, which demonstrates the really big difference between just normal, quite nice stereo sound and tremendous sounding 5-1 sound. But before we do that, I'm going to show you a little bit about how we do just one small detail from the game, which is a particle effect, which is one of the things I'm responsible for. Yeah, this is one particle for a specific spell for the demonologist. And there are thousands and thousands of particles in the game, all looking and feeling different. This is one of them. It's a planar shift. It's a friendly spell, and it looks like. Hold on. Let's hope this works now. Yeah, here we go. Everybody can see that? Yeah. And that's the way it is presented to me as a sound designer. On top of, I also get a documentation of how it's supposed to sound and what elements I'm supposed to use. And based on that, I start creating, of course, a lot of sounds from. I use libraries, I use a lot of live recordings. We create crazy sounds with synths, with all kinds of software applications. And some of the sounds I created for that particular one was twisty loop stuff. It's like a breathing sound, some backwards breathing and stuff like that. Another one is more like a vocal claustrophobic type sound, which is like, which is based on the human voice, of course, as you can hear. And you need some pulses, like, and some, a fireball is always a good thing, and so forth. And all those sounds, there are many more than these, goes into something we call Scry, which is a kind of a high-level programming interface that we have developed. And that this is kind of where all the sounds. This isn't used for more things than sound, but I'm going to talk about the sound part of it. This is kind of a scripting tool where we can set the rules for each and every sound and how it's randomized, what filters to use, delays, real-time filtering, and DSP stuff, and so forth. It can do almost whatever you want it to do. It's just the imagination which kind of sets the limits. So in this case, we have the same sounds as we heard in the sound editor. Let's see if we can find them. Like, here is probably one of them. Yeah, and here's another one. And as you can see, there's kind of a flow of sounds and parameters that are set in this script. So if I run this script, it will sound something like this. And that is the script that runs every
Awesome.
Time the player runs that particle or runs that spell, meaning that it will do some variations every time. It will sound more or less the same, but it will give some variation, which takes away some of the feeling of it being too repetitive. So let's see the spell with sound. Sounds like this. Oh, sorry. And if we see that
That's awesome.
And if you see that in context, here we are in the game as at Tatar's Beach. And if I throw the same particle here, you can see. That's a little bit about the flow of.
Every spell should do that.
That's awesome.
So that's just one of hundreds and hundreds, well, thousands of spells. Because, like, this is another one. And all of the particles have that same flow of scripting and advanced kind of multi-layer sound stuff. Same goes for animations, which has a lot of keyframes, which also run scripts. Music, the lot. So it's a lot of work just to do one simple little thing. But it gives variety and it brings the world to life. So that's that. Kind of quick today, but that's the way it is. Then, some music stuff. I'm going to play a little bit of music from Cymeria. This is the Glowfin Mountains, which is kind of the snowy plateaus of that area. All the music is written by one Norwegian guy called Knut Haugen, which is a really, really talented fella. And we differentiate very specifically between the different part of the world. Stygian music has very different elements than this, and so with the Aquilonian stuff and Acheronian stuff and so forth. This is Cymeria. All the music in the game holds this level of quality. This is just not one track to show off press and stuff like that. Everything sounds at this quality level. And I'm going to start off by playing it as normal stereo, and then switch a few times back and forth so you can really hear the difference. So let's see. This is normal stereo, sounds just nice, nothing wrong with it. But it's when you really get the 5-1 sound, you can hear it's really coming to life. This is 5-1. Back to stereo. It's kind of... You can just listen through it.
Is that the same lady awesome. Who did the bar trailer story?
Yeah, I think it is.
Yes, it is.
I forgot her name. But
a woman called Helene Baxler. She's a Norwegian folk song artist who really made it big with kind of mixing folk, Norwegian folk music and kind of jazz, popular music and so forth. She's touring the world and we have been fortunate enough to have her on the team. On top of that, we're also doing a lot of, well, the music itself, kind of the basis of the music is sample based. Mm-hmm. But we do live choir, live singers like that, live solo singers, live solo instruments, like all the violin parts have been dubbed with real violins as well. Mm. And also live woodwinds and so forth. So it's kind of a hybrid between synthetic orchestra and live players to give it that extra touch.